Okay, students, in the last discussion, I told you that orbits are a delicate balance between the gravitational force and speed. And the way Isaac Newton originally thought about this, this is called Newton's canon. I'm sorry I'm pointing with a mouse cursor here. It's just the best I can do at the moment here. Is he sort of had a thought experiment where he thought gravity would work like this. He put a cannon, he visualized a cannon sitting on top of a planet here like the Earth. And what he wanted to do was shoot cannonballs out of the cannon, sort of in this direction right here, going this way towards the right. And he wanted to see what would happen as the cannonballs were shot at different speeds. Now, just imagine that the cannonball is right here where the mouse cursor is. Gravity is always going to pull these cannonballs down towards the Earth, where the speed is always going to be this way coming out of the cannon. So we sort of see that combination of the orbit thing where the velocity could be over towards the right and gravity would be straight down. So let's just watch what happens here. Okay, I'll clear the tracks and I'll fire a cannonball at 1,000 meters per second out of the cannon. Let's watch what happens. Fire. And it just falls. So see, it came out of the cannon a little bit here. It did have the speed this way, but gravity was so strong that it pulled it right down and hit the Earth like this. So let's keep going. Let's go a little faster. Let's go maybe to 2,000. Doing a little better. The velocity still came straight out this way, but gravity pulled the ball straight down like that. Let's keep going. 3,000. Off it goes, off it goes, off it goes, and bang, right there. So it sort of hit right there now. Came all the way out. The velocity was pretty clear. You can even see this little curvature starting to develop, but gravity still won, and the ball hit the Earth still. Let's keep going. 4,000. And fire. So here it comes, and there it goes. Pretty good, and boom, like that. So see, we're getting some nice curvature. Things start to look like circles. Still a collision with the Earth, so it didn't quite work out. But remember, orbits are that delicate balance between gravity and speed, and I obviously haven't found that balance yet, so I'm going to keep going here with the speeds. Let me go up to 5,000, see what happens. So here it's going to turn. This might actually be a pretty good one here. Off it goes. See, so gravity is desperately trying to pull this cannonball in towards the Earth, no matter where it goes, but we gave it so much speed that the Earth kind of curves out of the way as it goes, and it looks like we're getting a pretty nice orbit going here at the moment. Let's see if it goes all the way around and kind of reproduces itself. And it looks like it does. Looks like it's going to do it. So right there at 5, looks like it hit the cannon again. But look at this beautiful orbit that we got going all the way around. We found the balance between speed and velocity. Just for the heck of it, looks like 5,000 works. What if I put in 4,500? All right, let's see with this one. So it's a little bit slower. And you can see the slowness having its effect in there. The Earth is winning. Gravity is winning. It's pulling in. It looks like we're going to get a collision right about, ooh, maybe not, maybe not. Okay, yeah, looks like we missed it. Looks like we missed the Earth, and looks like we're able to achieve sort of a different orbit at a slower speed that way. Good. And let me just go down a little more. Let's see if we can just get a collision there at the very end. Here comes 4,200, and looks like, are we gonna collide? Yeah, bang, right there, we're gonna collide. So it looks like somewhere between 4,500 and 5,000 is the balance speed that we need. Let me go all the way up to 7,000 now and give it a fire. Maybe clear some tracks and watch. If it's too fast, of course the speed can overcome gravity and the cannonball looks like it'll just be lost into outer space. Now in practice, if we stood here for a very, very, very long time, the cannonball would eventually get sucked all the way back and hit the Earth. But looks like we won't wait for that. So you see speeds like 7,000 are too large. Once again, the balance just isn't there. So this idea called Newton's cannon, this is what Newton originally thought. A large cannon on top of a planet. What would happen if I experimented with launching at a different speed? And you can see at some point an orbit is achieved. And that was a big step of his in explaining how the solar system works.